world away no matter what you, huh?
Hello, you are tuning in here with Our Truth and your host here, Rachel and
Sandra Taylor.
And we will be talking to you guys today about a serious subject matter that comes up in every woman's conversation. Sandra and I are just kicking it here today, you know, and it's kind of like a girl couch talk, you know, just having conversation. You're having conversations with your girlfriends, you know, and a topic comes up. One of the girls decides to say, what are the risks of falling in love with a convict? So that's what we're talking about today. And one of the things, one of the latest stories that came up today was the sexy eye convict. You remember that story, Sandra?
I do remember that story. He's a very nice looking young man.
Mm-hmm.
But what was he in jail for? You know, and whatever he's in jail for, how long has he been in there? And when he gets out, what can he do?
Yeah, exactly. But, you know, before we even get past that point, the public, the media, the people all over the world that saw that came across the media, the first thing, they didn't even care about what he did. They were so focused on, oh, he can be a model. You know, they wanted, you know, companies wanted to offer him jobs based off his looks, not even concerned about his background, but they were more so on, he could be a model. He has those beautiful eyes. And don't get me wrong, when you look at him, you're like, oh, he is kind of handsome, you know, but okay, what this brother did, you know, and I think what was the story that he robbed somebody and stole, was it robbery or something like that?
I have no idea. I don't even know. But that's the same thing. That's just like all of the other high profile people. I mean, there's a lot of celebrities out there that have been to jail.
Oh, yeah.
Chris Brown, Amanda Bynes. Who was that? Robert Downey Jr. He stayed in prison for a while, but they still come out. They still clean up themselves and they can still make money.
Mm-hmm.
So having a criminal background does not stop you from that industry.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it might stop you from some, but not that industry.
Would you say that because they have that background, because they are an ex-con, should they have a second chance in starting their life over? Or what would you say about that?
Everybody should have a second chance.
Mm-hmm.
Some people third and fourth. It just all depends on that person. If they really want me dating, I have dated people that have been to prison.
Mm-hmm.
But this one particular guy that I met, he was like 45 years old. And the things that he told me he had been to jail for, not just once or twice, several times within the course of 25 years, I can't comprehend that. I mean, what kind of job can you get having that extensive criminal record?
Right.
It was beyond my comprehension. What can you do to help me? I mean, I don't want a man to take care of me, but I'm not taking care of a man. So, I mean, what can you do after that?
Yeah.
You're going to have to basically start your own business,
right,
or something like that, which means that it costs money. Where are you getting the money from?
Mm-hmm.
Not me.
Yeah.
I'm trying to take care of me and mine.
Yeah. You know, recently I was doing an interview and I met this guy at the National Black Book Festival. And this guy that I walked up on, he had like, you know, he was an author of a book. And I got to talking with him and everything, and he was like, you know, I was an ex-con, and, you know, I've done this, and I've done that. He didn't tell me what he did to get into prison.
Right.
But he was just telling me, you know, the good things that he's done since he's been out. And it really gave me a different perspective on people who's been to prison.
Right.
To really not judge a book by its cover.
Right.
Simply because his background and what he told me is that, you know, he started a clothing store. He started a sugar scrub and, you know, he made all these products for himself.
Right.
He started his own publishing company.
Right.
he's done so many things. He's moved through so many barriers,
right.
To make his way to a successful author.
Right.
You know. So with that, it gave me a different perspective. But when you're out on the dating scene,
right,
and you know the guys come up to you and they're like, you know, what's up, little mama? How you doing? Can I holler at you for a second? I mean, what is your take? How do you, if you come across someone, how do you find out first in a dating scene if they are an ex-con? Like, put me in the scenery of, give us a visual of Sandra out there on a dating scene. What are some of the first things that you do?
Okay, that is not one of the first things that I ask.
Okay.
First of all, we have to have a conversation and see if our personalities are going to clash or not. That's the first thing, because whether you go to jail or not, if we're not going to mesh, really doesn't make a difference.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so that's something that'll come into the conversation eventually. Mm-hmm. You know, but the first thing, you know, first of all, I do date younger guys, because older guys want to stay in the house, and I'm not staying in the house. You can't keep me in the house.
Yeah,
you know, I cook sometimes when I feel like it, and if I don't, I'm not. So if you want to cook her, there's a door.
Yeah.
You know. But other than that, I mean, you just have to talk and go places and see if our personalities mesh, if we have fun together. My main thing is laughter.
Mm-hmm.
If we're not laughing,
Yeah.
You know, I mean, life is too short to be serious all the time. I want to go out there and have some fun, go dancing. I sing in a band, so of course you have to come hear me sing in a band, and just do different things. I like to travel and just like to hang out and just have some fun and just laugh at whatever.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know, a lot of viewers out there may be asking, why is she asking Sandra, how is she on a dating scene? Well, obviously because she's single. I'm not single, so that's why I'm asking her, you know, because she's in the today's dating scene. It's awesome that, you know, you take those steps in finding out, because you want to make sure that the person you get involved with, you know, a little bit of something about them.
Right.
So that's really awesome. What do you think some of the risks are when you're dating an ex-convict? What are some of the things that we, you know, will cross your mind? What are some of the things that we think about?
First of all, if he's an axe murderer,
mm-hmm.
I mean, what did he do to land himself in prison?
Exactly.
And how long was he there? And how many times has he been there? Have you not learned your lesson? And come on now, get a grip.
That's important, you know, and because, you know, having kids as well, you know, are you a child molester? You know, ladies out there on the dating scene, these are some of the things you want to know. You know, has he been to jail for burglary? Has he been to jail for murdering? I mean, you don't want to be in your shower one late night and, you know, somebody creeping in your door, which is supposed to be your boyfriend, you know, or somebody that you kicking it with, and this dude did not all of a sudden went crazy. You know, and he's coming after you.
Psycho.
So, yes. So you want to know who you're dealing with. And right now, we have to get ready to go to a break. But make sure you stay tuned to Our Truth, and we will come back with some information on the risk of dating a convict. And we are back from our quick break. We had to pay a couple of bills, y'all. But on this topic that we're discussing today, the risk of falling in love with the convict, got some statistics for y'all in regards to our African-American men. The Kaiser Family Foundation reported that the percentage of young African-Americans men in prison in nearly three times that of Hispanic men and nearly seven times that of white men. African-American men are about 14% of the population, and yet they make up 40% of the prison population. And this does not include men on parole. So as a young African-American female, it is inevitable that we, you know, date a guy who has been to court or jail. Isn't that something?
Wow.
You know, it's you know, it's kind of like a every one in eight man that approaches you, they didn't been to jail or something close to it.
Right.
You know?
Well, my third husband went to jail.
Are you serious?
Yeah, he went to prison for a couple of years.
Him went there,
no,
girl?
No. That was before I met him.
Oh, man.
You know? But, you know, that happens. He was fighting. People got hurt, you know?
Oh.
So, you know, that's, you know, water under the bridge. I mean, he was just once. You know, now, if he go around beating people and going to jail, then I got a problem with that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but it was a self-defense type thing, and, you know.
And he still went to jail.
Yeah.
Well, we ain't going to even talk about that, because that's a different story.
Right.
You know, we have some situations that's been aired on the news to where, you know, you actually have criminals trying to get into someone's home.
Right.
And depending on what race you are, and you defend yourself, you either go into jail or you're not.
Right.
But we're not going to get into that. That's another topic for another day.
Right.
According to Prison Talk 2014, I had got some information. This Prison Talk is a website.
Okay.
They said that the advantage of dating someone who has been to prison.
Wait a minute. There's advantages.
Yes, ma'am, girl, there's advantages.
Please tell me the advantages.
Yes, ma'am. It says you get to know the inmate through letters.
Oh, come on now. Anybody can write a letter. I can write a letter. I can write a letter you wouldn't believe.
You know, they have, you know, we have to consider that they have some women out there.
Right.
That they want them a convict. They want them a little bit of that. They don't mind getting to know him through a letter, you know. So, and then another thing that they say is, you know, you have enough time before sex. That's the other advantage.
Are we talking like 20 years? So, you know, if he had 20 years, what are you doing while you're waiting on him for 20 years?
It's crazy, I know, but this is their advantage. This is according to Prison Talk.
Mm.
The other thing was you have someone who would even eventually get out and not ask you to adapt to their career or location.
Yeah, but, you know, it depends on what they went in there for. What if they can't get a position?
But think
then
about
what?
It. But listen, they won't ask you to adapt to their career or location. Why is that?
Well, because I just got out of jail.
They don't have no
one.
Career. Okay. Exactly. Exactly.
So I'm coming with you.
I'm coming with
mama.
You.
I'm a little mama. Okay.
Yes. No. Yes. So that's funny. But my input is that I kind of agree for those who are into dating convicts with one and two. Yeah. You might get a little chance to get to know him through letter. And yeah. You have enough time to know them before you decide to have sex with them. But is what they saying in that letter true?
Yeah.
You know, because when you have a lot of time on your hands, you know, some of that may be true. You
right.
know, some of it may, you never know what their motive is.
Right.
You know, but all in all, it's still a risk.
Right. I mean, because if you get to know a person in person.
Mm-hmm.
And they lie. They can mm-hmm. still lie on the letter. Mm-hmm. So what's the difference?
Mm-hmm. Now, let me say this. You bring this guy home. You guys get to know each other. And how do you bring this to your family?
Bring what to my family?
I'm dating this guy. You know when you're dating a new guy.
That girl, he just got out of jail.
Yes. And your family like, so where you know him from?
Well, first of all, I have quite a few family members that's been to jail. I've been to jail once. What about you? You ever been to jail?
Wait a minute.
Girl, wait. No. It was for a traffic ticket that I totally forgot about, and it went into warrants. You know, and when the guy stopped me, when he went back and he ran my driver's license, he was like, "We have a problem." I was like, "I already know." I gotta go get my car. Don't let them borrow my car. That's money.
Yeah.
So, but wait a minute. I went to the substation. Mm-hmm. And the guy was like, "Well, okay, all you have to do is just get $300. I'm not going to put you in a cell. You want to go to a trail ride?" "No, not after you just took me to jail. I'm not going no trail ride. You should have told me that before you took me to jail." Okay, halfway to jail, rather. Mm-hmm. So.
Wow. No, to answer your question, I have not been to jail. I have not. Not even close. So my record is pretty clean.
Okay.
Thank goodness. That's scary. That's really scary.
Yeah, it was. I mean, in the ride behind, in the back of the car, you know, I was like, okay, it's kind of small back here. It was funny. But yeah, that was the only time.
Those kinda with your warrants, you know, with your warrants, get them warrants taken care of. Y'all don't want to be sitting in the back seat of those cars. So
a little bit of seat, yeah.
Yeah. Here are some of the disadvantages according to the Prison Talk 2014.
And this should be longer than the advantages, correct?
No.
Wow.
Actually, it's not, because it says when released, the correctional system has strict guidelines for them,
okay,
which we all know.
Right.
So most times when requirements are not met, because they fall to, you know, they fail to, you know, abide by those guidelines.
Right.
They got to go back.
Right.
You know, some of them, they have the first chance, second chance, third chance. Maybe if you mess up the first time, that's
right.
just it,
right.
you know, and then they're back in a slammer. But my thing is, again, that's another risk
right.
that you take in dating a convict. So my question to the audience, to the viewers, to the listeners, everyone out there, is this risk worth it? Do you think it's worth it?
And how long is he going to be on paper? You know how they say, "I'm on paper." How long is he? I mean, we talking 10 years that you not supposed to drink or act, you know, that's a long time.
Yeah.
For you to be on paper. Now, if it's a couple years, then maybe. Mm-hmm. 10 years, come on now. That's a long time for you not to do certain things, mm-hmm. to not go back to prison.
Mm-hmm.
So to me, that would be pretty hard.
You know what? While you were sitting there explaining it, I was thinking about something, you know, when you're out with your girls and everything, and, you know, they're like, "Oh, I have to, I'm with this guy, and, oh my gosh, y'all, we have to go to break. But when we come back, I am going to tell you what the ladies would say when they're out on a break and they have a guy that's been in jail after this break." And we are back, and you are tuning in here with Our Truth. Sandra, got a question.
Watch out there now. Okay.
Like I said before we went on break, you're out with your girlfriends.
Okay.
And, you know, one of your girlfriends are like, "Hey, you know, y'all, I can't be doing all that because my man might get upset with me." And y'all are like, "Where your man at? He locked up." What would be your response to that?
Well, how he gonna know you doing something if he locked up?
I mean,
you gonna be stupid and tell him in a letter? Okay.
I don't know. What I'm thinking is, you know, she's one of the good girls.
What does that mean? What's a good girl?
She don't want to. They have a commitment.
Well, stay at home. If you that committed, while he in jail, stay at home. Yeah.
Yes, that's. Okay. I mean, because think about it. Remember when T.I. was in jail.
Right.
And Tiny, I think they had the they had their reality show going, but he was in jail.
Right.
She was still carrying on with the reality show. And
right.
I remember one setting to where I think she went out with some girlfriends or something. I can't remember the details of it, but I remember she went in the back room because she told him he got a phone call. She had got the phone call.
Right.
And, you know, she was explaining to him, oh, me and the girls, we just, you know, we just chilling. You know how she talks.
Right.
We just chilling. We just doing this and that. And, you know, I wore this and I wore that. And the way the scene went, it seemed like there was an issue with that.
Issue with what she was doing or what she was wearing?
What she
or
was
both.
Doing. You know, where she was, who she was hanging with, that whole deal. But remind you, he was in jail at that
right.
time. And so, and you know what? I don't even think she made it to the event. She actually ended up not going. She went to the girl's house and she was like, you know what, y'all, I'm not going to go. And they was like, why? You know, what's girl, what's wrong with you? You know, T.I. is locked up. Have you some fun.
He would have saw it on the episode.
He would have saw it on the episode.
He would have saw it on the episode.
So
on cable TV or whatever. He got me. No, okay.
Yeah,
exactly. I love you, baby. Gotta go. I'm going to take a shower and go to bed. Going to the party.
Yeah.
Because you made a choice to do what you did to get yourself back in that jail. So.
Again, those are the risks, you know, dating a convict.
Right.
Those are the risks of falling in love with a convict.
Right.
So. It's crazy.
Yeah.
Now, picture this. You go to your family.
Right.
We getting married.
Again? Okay.
No, not again. We're not talking about you.
That's what I'm going to say. Again. Who when? Where y'all going? Okay.
Yeah, yeah. No, we're getting married. And it comes down to the list.
What is the list? What does that mean? What is the list?
You know, the people you want to invite to your wedding.
Oh.
The discussion, I can just imagine the discussion would be, okay, who are you bringing to our wedding? I'm going to bring Akon and them. You know Akon, right?
Right.
Yeah, he was in jail. I'm just thinking of some names. I'm going to bring two.
So it's going to be like a convict food festival type thing. So we just going, if you want a convict, come to our wedding, you can pick out one. Yeah.
You know, all in all.
So they're going to be in the lineup. Ha! You got it!
Turn.
For real.
Yeah. Turn. You know, take your picture. Oh,
right.
That's just funny. But, you know, all in all, you know, we say all of this to our viewers out there to say, you know, if that's something you want to do, that's totally up to you, you know. We can't pick your friends, your husband, your wife. For you, you know, if that's the lifestyle you want to lead, I mean, God bless you, because it is simply a huge risk in dating a convict. It could be good or it could be really bad, you know, but it's up to you, you know, if you really want to take that risk. It's a thin line,
right?
You know, but it's what they want to do. Sandra, do you have any closing words or anything you want to put out there?
Okay. With my kids, I've always told them what you do have consequences. So you always have to weigh the good and the bad. Now, if you're going to go with someone that's a convict, I mean, not go and just seek them out, but it just happened to be, you still have to weigh the pros from the cons of dating a convict, you know, what was he in there for, what the lifestyle is going to be after he get out, how long he's going to be on paper. All of that stuff has a bearing on your life. Are you willing to risk that? You know, so, but that's across the board what life altogether. Whatever you do have consequences, whether it's good or bad, you are going to have to be the one that's going to suffer for it, whether, like I say, whether it's good or bad. So make a conscious decision on who you're getting involved with, who you're marrying, multiple marriages. I mean, but that's a whole nother story too, you know. But to me, it's just consequences of everything that you do.
Yes. I totally agree with what she says. And then also, know what you're getting involved in. Everybody deserves a second chance, because guess what? If you got caught, you be in jail too. We can all attest, right, and say, hey, I just didn't get caught. I got lucky. So thank you guys for listening in on us, watching us. It's been a pleasure. You've been here with Our Truth. If you want to share your truth with Our Truth, contact us at our.truth@yahoo.com. And this is your host, Rachel.
And Sandra Taylor.
And it's been a pleasure talking to you today. It was nothing but the truth, and it's all you can do. All you've ever done before, no matter what you've chosen, it was right.
You were always right.
Every time you will do it, everything you've had to say, I know it was right. It was the truth. It was nothing but the truth. Get up!